World proudly brings you the International Netball Series. We love netball as much as you do.
When I take the court, I aim for 100%. Anything other than a win is not an option.
Has given the Silver Ferns a serious shake-up. Can New Zealand redeem itself tonight? Combinations, complacency, whatever the problem, something's got to change.
We actually have to do things with a purpose. As we've been told, trying is for losers. So we really need to go out there and you know, make it happen for ourselves.
Welcome to the Energy Event Centre in Rotorua for the Silver Ferns' second test against the World 7. A bit of added pressure tonight. This is the series. The Silver Ferns want to stay in it, they better. Good evening, glad you could join us. I'm Tony Street, and it wasn't the start to the season the Silver Ferns were hoping for. A four-goal shock loss to the World 7, and now they're forced to play catch-up netball. Casey Williams has come out and said the loss was unacceptable, so you'd expect an increased performance tonight. Jordan Vandermeid is out with the crowd, and Jordan, what's the feeling out there from the crowd? Do they think the Ferns can get up on this one?
Well, here in the forecourt, I would have thought that this crowd would have been wanting blood after the loss on Monday against the World 7 in Wellington. But I can tell you that Rotorua is here in force and they are behind our Silver Ferns. But you do get the feeling that that mood is going to change. If Ruth Aiken and the girls don't get the result that we need, the result we want on the court tonight. And trust me, that's the last thing they need ahead of a busy and intense international series. After tonight's second test in Rotorua, the Silver Ferns then head up north to Auckland for the third and final match against the World 7. Five tests against the Australian Diamonds follow, the first in Sydney, one in Melbourne, and then the final test on Aussie soil in Brisbane. The road trip travels back to New Zealand for the final two tests, Invercargill and the big decider in Auckland. Then the long haul across to Manchester for the World Series. It's a one-off test against England and Bath before stopping off in Jamaica to play them on the way home.
World 7 coach Julie Fitzgerald has a tough decision to make tonight. She had goal shoot Catherine Latu, who was player of the match on Monday, but then she has two shooters, Romelda Aiken and Louisa Brownfield, sitting on the bench. Who will she go with in her starting seven tonight? Here's Jordan with the World 7.
Two changes to the World 7 starting lineup. England's Louisa Brownfield replaces Catherine Latu at goal shoot, while Megan Dean remains at goal attack. The second new player is also English, Tamsin Greenway at wing attack. Natasha Chocolate is at centre with Petter Scholes at wing defence. They're keeping the same defensive end though. Sonia McCloma is at goal defence with Jeeva Mentor at goalkeep, making it all English affair. So the World 7's bench is stacked with shooters. Coach Julie Fitzgerald says, though, her side still has a lot to give.
A few things I think we can do better defensively. There's a few switches and changes and things that I think we can pull off a little bit better. And attacking-wise, when we change the lineup, we'll have to change the tactics a little bit as well. Latu gave us a very easy game plan and a very set style to play to. If we take her out of there and bring in different combinations, then we'll have to change the plan a little bit.
She gets the nod to start game two against the Silver Ferns.
You'd have to feel a little bit gutted if you were Catherine Latu, player of the match, and then you get benched. Did you expect that, Kerry?
Yeah, well, I think that Julie Fitzgerald is keeping the Silver Ferns coaching staff guessing. She's got such a wealth of talent on that bench. She's got so much firepower that any subtle changes, even as subtle as this, will keep those Silver Ferns guessing.
OK, Brownfield and Dean. Now, they are the only two shooters in the World 7 that haven't played together. So why would she put that out?
Well, you know, she must have a lot of confidence in Dean. Dean obviously spent some time with Catherine Latu before. She also has spent a small amount of time on court with Romelda Aiken. But, you know, she's such a great player and she creates so much space that she's confident she can do the job with any shooter.
OK, well, it's another formidable-looking World 7 lineup. Stay with us after the break. We'll have the Silver Ferns for for the Silver Ferns in Wellington. So will Ruth Aiken tinker with her starting lineup tonight? Bearing in mind Maria Tutaia has a bit of a back strain. Here's Jordan with the Silver Ferns lineup.
The Silver Ferns have made two changes to the team that started on Monday. The first to the shooting circle. Irene van Dijk is still at goal shoot, but Anna Thompson earns her first cap at goal attack. The midcourt stays the same with Liana Barrett-Chase at wing attack, Timopata George is at centre, and Laura Langman at wing defence. Tonight, Jolene Henry is the other change, coming off the bench to start at goal defence, with captain Casey Williams at goal keep. So watch out for Maria Tutaia coming off the bench. For coach Ruth Aiken tonight, not only is it pressure, but it's all about doing the basics well.
If things are not working, we've got to change them positively rather than negatively, and not just because we haven't worked hard enough at it. But we do have to be able to read things a bit more. We have to adjust to umpires even more. I thought the umpiring was fine, but I thought the basic skill level that we showed at times was just not good enough. So it's that attention to detail in terms of footwork. Through a third, those things are just the absolute givens.
Silver Ferns, but none in the midcourt. Ruth Aiken obviously looking to consolidate in there.
Well, I'm not surprised really. That midcourt has got so much potential. We saw glimpses of it the other night, didn't we? But I just think they've got to link together and back themselves, and I think we'll see the flair that they've got. Liana Barrett-Chase moving into the wing attack position from centre. She just needs a wee bit more movement off the ball because she is short in stature, so she's got to create good space for herself. Use the entire court area. And Liana Barrett, Laura Langman in the wing defence position did quite well defensively but needs to really play a bit more on attack, make herself available a bit more in that area.
Well, I'll tell you, someone who did impress me in game one, that was Jolene Henry. She came off the bench and was impressive, and she's been shown, well, the selectors have shown faith in her. She's been given the nod to start tonight at goal defence.
She certainly was impressive, Jenny May. Kerry, do you think Jolene Henry deserves a start ahead of Katrina Grant?
Yeah, look, I agree. She gets ball outside the circle. She wasn't afraid to hunt up court. She brings that ball through beautifully, and I thought that she actually lifted the whole team with her fieriness on the court, and they came back while she was on, so she deserves a start.
A bit of mongrel, that's what I like to see. The other big call-up, Anna Thompson, she's the new cap. She'll have some nerves rattling tonight. How do you think she'll go?
Look, she needs a start because she needs to get out there and show what she's got. She's a specialist goal attack. It's something that Maria Tutaia came from a goal shoot background. Hopefully Anna Thompson can use her skills and her knowledge of moving the circle to allow Van Dijk to play her own game.
Okay, good to see that circle moving. Now, Jolene Henry, goal defence, she came on at half-time on Monday night. She is so key at bringing the ball through the court. Can she add a bit of spark tonight?
definitely a different breed from the attackers, and you know, when you're throffing at the mouth and you're looking at your other defenders, you know you're in a really good space. Very fiercely competitive in myself, and I think, you know, that real stubbornness shows when if I'm beaten at something, I'll make damn sure it's not going to happen again. When I'm out there on court, it's nothing but the ball. Everything else kind of doesn't seem to matter, and that's why you play, is for the love and pure want of the game. When everything else can go aside, and you're playing for that instance, for that moment, it really is a real honour to get out there and sing your national anthem and know that you're representing the rest of the country. And, you know, it's pretty awesome. It's pretty mean.
These Silver Ferns with one word, it would be revenge. I tell you what, there is a fire in these girls' eyes that maybe we were lacking a little bit on Monday in Wellington, but that all has changed. And of course, another interesting point is tonight in warm-up, Casey Williams, very vocal. Of course, she doesn't want to start her captaincy with two losses. So good luck to the girls, but from here courtside, we're going to pass it to former Silver Fern. It is Jenny May Coffin and Julie Cope.
Thanks, Jordan. Yes, plenty riding on tonight's second test for the Silver Ferns. A patchy, error-ridden performance in game one. Plenty of pressure from within the camp for individuals to step up as the teams come onto court. I have no doubt, though, we'll see a committed Ferns team tonight. The World Seven showing that experience and patience, what that can produce. And they won't want it to be a one-off with pride and reputations on the line. She is the debutante this evening, Anna Thompson from Canterbury. She'll be paired up with Liana Barrett-Chase and Timmy Pettigrew-George in the midcourt. She's an old campaigner now, as Laura Langman, just at the tender age of 23 years. And captain, fantastic, Casey Williams. Well, tonight promises to be a cracker in front of a capacity crowd here at the Energy Event Centre in Rotorua. Silver Ferns, they'll need to pick themselves up after a shock loss on Monday night by 4 goals. As we stand by for the anthem this evening, which will be sung by the Lady Killers.
Ladies and gentlemen, the umpires for tonight's match are Paul Ferguson and Michelle Tapard. The reserve umpire is Kathy Jashari. Please stand for the New Zealand National Anthem sung by the Lady Killers.
Yeah.
Aotearoa, the Silver Ferns, with the chance to redeem themselves. And Julie, I would expect to see a Silver Ferns team on fire after what happened on Monday night.
Well, they'll certainly be disappointed in their performance. And talking to Ruth Aiken this afternoon, I know they were, the players and the management of the team, and expecting a lot more from them tonight. There she is, Anna Thompson, on the screen there, lining up against Sonia McClomer in her debut test.
And here we have the ball carrier for this evening is Nicole Acton from Johnfull College Intermediate. Her favourite player is none other than Casey Williams. Yes, it's all go here in Aotearoa with the World 7 taking the first centre pass in game 2 against the Silver Ferns. And your sideline commentator for this evening is former player turned coach Kerry Wills. Kerry, atmosphere in here is pretty good.
Pretty electric, and I have to agree with Jordan, the Silver Ferns warm-up was pretty intense. They're looking very focused. Conversely, the World 7 high fives all round, so it'll be an interesting game to watch.
Big pass coming from the sideline, or from the transverse line, I should say, from Laura Langman.
Yes, and that's what, you know, we spoke briefly, touched briefly on at the top of the show, Jenny May, just that attacking play from Langman. I know Ruth Aiken was wanting more in that area from her, because she is strong at driving that ball through court and looking into the circle for the feed.
Dean has to go all the way over to Chocolate. Langman got a hand to it,
as did Casey Williams.
So a much better start from the Silver Ferns defensively. Casey Williams early getting around Brownfield.
Yes, playing against a different style of player, of course, at goal shoot tonight. Louisa Brownfield, taller, as we said, than Latu, but doesn't have that same hold, the same body presence, the strength of body.
Langman finds Timipata George, who's looking for the fast passing cut. Thompson, a little bit nervous. First shot at goal.
Yes, and over the long reach of McClomer.
Thought that one was going to bounce out. Great start for Anna Thompson.
That's the one you want, isn't it? Your first international, first shot in.
To Greenway, to Dean, back to Greenway. She's looking for her teammates, but it's a held ball. Good defence from the Silver Ferns.
Great work, good start. Henry and Williams finished the game well the other evening. They're starting well tonight. Oh, good tip from Chocolate in the mid. She was certainly a strength for them in the first test.
Chocolate with the ball in hand. Has to go all the way to Greenway, the England international.
Obstruction wing defence.
She's been playing her netball in Australia for the last couple of years. As Greenway, Dean with the shot.
Solid on it. No misses at goal in the opening stages.
The patience here from the Silver Ferns.
Yes, certainly the first option is to look up court, but if there's nothing on, play it sideways.
Thank you.
And then wait for the opening.
McClomer.
Couldn't have got much closer.
No,
I
it's
think.
Right. Always trying to push things. Yes. Sonia McClomer. 85 caps for England.
Well, there's the first miss, and the call was that Van Dijk came from out of court when she got that rebound.
McClomer, it's Dean, has to go back to Scholes. Greenway. Yes, Casey Williams got those hands over the ball, but Megan Dean is always there to clean things up.
Yeah, tidied up well, didn't she?
And finishes it as well. Megan Dean, 20 caps for Australia.
Yes, 34 years of age, and in fact, four of the players in the World 7 over 30.
Good to see, Julie,
yes,
good to see.
Yes, keep the over 30s in the game, Jenny May. We might see a return for you yet.
Oh, jeepers, not sure about that. Brownfield looks comfortable. Oh, so the World 7 out to a 3-goal lead against the Silver Ferns with just 5 minutes or under 5 minutes played in the second test. Nicely placed pass from Timu Parajorge, but a good hold too from Van Dijk.
Well, looking at this New Zealand team, there are changes in every area of the court, aren't there, from what we've seen in previous years. This new combination on attack that you're looking at right now, the change that we saw in the first test in the mid, and then defensively with Henry and with Williams. We haven't seen that on the international field very much at all.
Well, we haven't seen it for a long time, but, well, Jolie Henry thought she got away with that one.
You're holding goalkeeper, in fact.
Henry called. No, it's Williams has been called for the contact. Brownfield making a great start to this match. Shooting at 100% so far, 4 from 4. Yes, held ball, no options on for Van Dijk.
Yes, McClymer really had Thompson tied up. Wasn't available to the ball.
And of course, Thompson and McClymer, they'll be used to playing against each other, their tactics or Canterbury Tactics teammates. And another held ball down the other end.
Well, they'll know each other's play well, won't they, in training, from training situations.
Megan Dean just giving some instructions to her teammates.
Yes, well, Megan Dean's been heavily involved in attack for the World 7 in this quarter, much more so than the other night. She's always a busy player, but I think she's making up a little bit for Greenway and Brownfield at this time.
Great shot from Thompson.
Yes, she's not afraid to put them up from distance. And that certainly gets in the mind of the defenders. You know, she's not one to pass it out too often.
Patience being shown here by the World 7, just happy to feed the ball back.
Greenway offloads to her English teammate, Brownfield. Brownfield, interestingly, one of the only players in the that hasn't played in the ANZ Championship. There are just two players, Scholes, who is playing at wing defence.
Lots of space there from the World 7.
And Brownfield.
Misunderstanding between Williams and also Henry. So after a close start, the Silver Ferns are lagging behind by 4 goals. Won't want that lead to stretch out too much further.
Yes, it's just on the attack end again for the Silver Ferns. It's getting that ball into the shooting circle.
I'm not sure what that was for. I thought Langman had that cleanly, but
I think it was a short pass, Jenny May, when she offloaded. So, unfortunately, after all the hard work.
Dean again, the creator, going outside the circle.
Yes, we applauded Latu the other evening, but there was some beautiful ball delivered from Dean, and she's certainly the general at the attack end of the court.
Well, we saw a lot of misunderstanding in that midcourt in game one, and we're starting to see it again between George and Barrett Chase. They're lucky, though, fortunate on this occasion that the World 7 have coughed the ball up.
Fine construction centre.
Big pass from Barrett Chase. Too big.
And again, as that ball came through court, just a little misunderstanding on attack. That time both Thompson and Barrett Chase in the same position. Or going for the same ball.
6 the difference here in Rotorua. And there's a timeout that's been called, this time by Timi Parajorge.
And I don't think there's too much injury involved in this one.
Oh.
Bit of a run, 6 goals up, the World 7.
Probably a little bit of frustration, I think, for the Silver Ferns. You can sort of see it in their body language and the way they're looking at each other on the court. So they'll want to tidy that up, and that's what this will be about.
So Jolene Henry also taking a little bit of time out. Such a good start from the Silver Ferns. Started well, the first couple of minutes started off with a hiss and a roar, but they've certainly dropped off the pace in the second spell of the first quarter.
Yes, that what they're searching for is that link between the midcourt and the shooters.
Yeah, just perhaps rushing things a little bit too much. If you look at the World 7, they're just quite happy to play the pockets and, you know, just let the ball go, but have a lot of patience.
No pressure on the World 7, is there? There's no pressure on them at all. Tons and tons of pressure on the Silver Ferns in this match, especially after losing the first. But also, the World 7 aren't doing anything flashy, are they? They're just doing the good, solid, basic things and doing them well. Basic skills.
So worrying signs early in this match against the World 7 for the Silver Ferns. Talked about cohesion. Need to see a bit more. So lagging behind by 6 goals. Scholes with the ball in hand. To Chocolate.
Just halfway through this first quarter, though, so plenty of time for the Silver Ferns to turn it around. And here's one break.
Oh, it's an offside call, I think.
But this is where that they let themselves down on in the first test. They didn't score off this valuable turnover ball, so let's see if they can manage it tonight. Nice cut, wasn't it? Yes, good work, Thompson. Cut the top of the circle, 2 defence back on Fungi.
Well, Scholes is doing a great job on Liana Barrett-Chase. She's really pushing her wide and asking her teammates to pass to her across the court. So they need to start getting that length like that in the game. Yes. So who's available for her, though?
You don't want to be pushed up court and turn around and have a defence standing in front of you. You want to create some space and be heading towards the goal if you can.
Thompson just rushed that shot a little bit. Irene van Dijk there to tidy up for her, though, underneath the basket.
Where you are now.
So Anna Thompson, just 23 years of age. And that was the pass that kept going in that first test. It always went from the wing attack back to Chocolate, or Dean back to Chocolate off the centre pass. Need to start picking that ball up.
Advantage obstruction stands up.
Greenway and Dean are being used predominantly off that centre pass for the World 7.
Well, another mistake from the Silver Ferns.
Just a shot of the coaches looking quite pensive. That, to me, looked like a planned move that went horribly wrong.
So if we just take a look at the turnovers here, and the Silver Ferns, unfortunately, leading that statistic.
Williams.
How athletic was that? George, almost as impressive. But again, it's those turnovers. When your teammates do such brilliant work, you need to reward them. Chocolate, nice positioning at the top of the circle, but she's been called for stepping by the umpire.
Well, they're the errors that were made. Here it is, the beautiful work from Casey Williams. Look at that.
That's amazing.
Just that. Beautifully with the away hand, wasn't it? And then the pole got in the way, but managed to dance herself around that as well. I think she'll be in Dancing with the Stars next time.
Thompson.
Yes,
Scholes called for the contact at the top of the circle. Free pass for George.
Yes, and just about didn't give it to Thompson either, and she had offered herself at the top of the circle. Needed to go perhaps slightly quicker.
And again, nice pocket in the back from Irene van Dijk, and nice delivery from Liana Barrett-Chase. Greenway. Scholes. Thompson. There's your father. And again, just that nice placement over the top of Casey Williams. Needs again to get her feet moving.
And that's the combinations. The English players playing together know each other's play, knows where to deliver it to Brownfield Greenway. She knows where she likes the ball pop.
And another mistake from the Silver Ferns. Unacceptable, really. goal defence.
It's just the error rate, isn't it?
Well, it's the sort of stuff you don't expect to see from the Silver Ferns. Casey Williams tidies things up after a missed shot. Now let's see what they can do with it.
Oh, just about a howl. Lucky to get away with that one.
Just the hesitation on that.
Oh, and again.
And if all else fails, throw it to the back. That's where the patience needs to come in.
And Irene van Dijk is struggling a little bit with Jeeva Mentor. She's not giving herself enough room on the base at times to get that ball at the back. So
yes, you did right, Kerry. Mentor playing in front of her and making it difficult for van Dijk. She's really jamming her on that baseline and at times forcing her out of court.
Well, this is going to be a very interesting quarter break talk from the Silver Ferns coaches, I think.
Yes, haven't even got to the double figures at this stage.
Well, I'd say there'd be a few stern words being said, and rightly so.
They certainly got into double figures in every quarter in the first test.
In each quarter. Again, just timing's off a little though.
And interestingly, the shooting stats for New Zealand, not so hot either, 70% to World 7's 93. So just the one miss from the World 7.
Oh, 7 the difference. Dear oh dear. Again, the Ferns having to go back. No one punching through that middle.
And they've got the players to do it. They've got that power and that speed off the mark.
Van Dijk with a rare miss. One shot that the Spurs dearly needed.
Vantage obstruction wing. Vantage contact goal attack.
And the World 7 just patiently plugging away.
No, it's just basic netball. Just turn.
Holding and moving. Playing into the space.
Persistent breaking wing attack, that's your warning.
It's a warning to Liana Barrett-Chase for persistent breaking on the World 7 centre pass.
Yes.
So she'll have to be careful. The Aussie umpires don't mind sending players off the court. And a turnover, but the Silver Ferns have only got seconds to get it down the other end to score off it. And another mistake from the Silver Ferns, and it has been an error-ridden performance from the Ferns. Not good signs as they go to the break behind the World 7, 15-7.
For more action after the break.
Well, welcome back to the Energy Event Centre here in Rotorua. We have just got the second quarter underway between the Silver Ferns and the World 7, and there have already been a couple of changes for the Silver Ferns. Not surprising when they are behind.
Second debutante on the court.
Yes, we do. Larissa Wilcox has come onto the court at wing defence, but we've also seen Maria Tutaia come on at goal attack. And a shift around in the midcourt, Liana Barrett-Chase has been benched, and Temepara George back into wing attack with Lauren Langman going into centre. So a host of changes for the Silver Ferns as they try and dig themselves out of this hole that they've got themselves into.
And the changes made very early. You don't often see them till the halftime break. But Coach Ruth Aiken ready to make it straight at that first quarter.
Well, the mistakes just keep continuing, though, for the Silver Ferns. So the crowd a bit stunned here in Rotorua, much like us, actually,
yes,
Julie, because...
Yes, absolutely. Just not the form you'd expect from these talented players. But they're up against a very polished side.
Advantage of stroke. Steppy. Free pass. Outside.
And a turnover here. Offside the call. So the Ferns have a chance.
Advantage contact and obstruction shooter. Advantage obstruction.
I don't remember the last time that a Silver Ferns team was kept into single, kept at single figures in the first quarter. Well, any quarter.
Certainly been a long time. I'll have to go back through my book, Jenny May. I'll do that for you and let you know at the next test.
Oh, Maria Tutahi comes on. Slots the first shot.
Just a beautiful clearing pass and no defence coming out for the intercept off that. Dean was right back deep. Opportunity there for Williams to have a look at it. Didn't come for it. Bit tied up with your own players at the moment.
Oh, I'd like to see that combination go around the other way. See Henry in the back with another mistake from the Ferns.
Mentor has it all over Irene van Dijk at the moment and has done in most quarters of the match, of this match and the first test.
And a great pass from McCloma. Megan Dean held her space wide and just went into it. Great timing underneath the post. Again, there's that same pass, always from the centre pass from Dean going back to Chocolate. Jolene Henry looked at it.
That's better work from Casey Williams. But again, almost losing it, really labouring that ball out of the defence end. So the World 7 very quick to turn onto defence from attack. Here it goes. Some lovely work straight up in the air, kept Brownfield on her back. Was finished off this time, thankfully.
But hey, we're into double figures for the first time this evening, the Silver Ferns.
Wilcox with that very Australian style delivery.
Yeah, it had too much on it for George.
Yes, flicked off her left hand.
Scholes.
The Silver Ferns just can't afford that kind of stuff as well. They're just pushing each other too far at times.
And great, oh, Williams, nothing's going right.
Yes, they could take a page out of the World 7 book and just do the basic things well and just take a little more time.
Contact centre outside the circle.
Chocolate finds Dean.
Obstruction, shot or pass.
Obstruction called on Williams.
Goal defence both, shot or pass.
Just not happy with the umpire's calls. She just has to get on with it though. 9-goal lead to the World 7.
Advantage offside. Wing defence contact. Yes. Goalkeeper.
Well, I'm a bit stunned, Julie. This is.
Yes, they don't seem to be having too much trouble on attack. And again, a fight for the ball off the rebound falls the World 7's way.
Casey Williams, she's working hard, trying to create something.
Trying to lead from the front, which good to see, but we're just not getting the ball.
The World 7 have only missed two shots and both their rebounds have been collected by themselves, not the Silver Ferns.
Henry went wide, thought the ball was going to go back into that pocket. World 7 too smart for that though, Megan Dean.
Stay on it!
Dear, oh dear.
Lucky Brownfield's hands were let her down.
Yes, keeper.
For the Silver Ferns.
Trying to construct contact in defence.
Peter Scholes has been proven to be a handful for both Temma Parra-George and Liana Barrett-Chase. She's just putting so much pressure outside.
I just think the experience of George, though, against the wily Scholes just might pay off in the end.
What a great lean that was from Mentor. Van Dijk looked at the umpire, pleading to say, well, she was within 3 feet. Beg to differ, though. She had a good 3 foot on her.
Well, Greenway was certainly had the better of Laura Langman in that first quarter of the match. I think Wilcox a little tighter on her, not giving her the same space as she had in the first quarter.
Yes.
She is, Tamsin Greenway.
17 caps for England, Tamsin Greenway.
Breaking goal attack.
Holding arm, goalkeeper.
Contact again on Casey Williams.
Yes.
12, the difference. Dejected Silver Ferns bench. And again, Mentor just staying tight on Van Dijk. Crowd not happy with that call, but there was nothing wrong with it. Mentor went straight up and down. Dean, a bit too much on that one. Rushed the pass. But I guess you can afford to do the odd one of those when you're leading by 12 goals.
I like what the World 7 are doing on attack. When they get that ball, they get their heads around early and look up court.
And again, this defence stifling the Silver Ferns attack. Tutaia.
That's better. Using the full complement of skills. A bounce pass that time. And a great hand from the defence of the World 7. Get the deflection.
Well, it's obviously the game plan, Kerry, but Tutaia is a goal attack. And even when Anna Thompson was on the court, tended to start back a little bit more rather than trying to help out up court.
Yeah, and just not the same speed as Anna Thompson's got around the circle, just that pass and cut. But, you know, no one's really standing out in the Silver Ferns team, so the coaches are forced to try everything, and I wouldn't be surprised to see more changes at half time, possibly in the defensive end.
Well, it's not good for the Silver Ferns.
And look at the shooting stats. Have we ever seen Irene van Dijk on 63%? Not for a long time. It just shows the damage that Jeeva Mentor is doing, both Mentor and McClymer, over that shot.
And Mentor's also getting a lot of ball off that Irene van Dijk by forcing her to that baseline, just sitting on top of her.
Well, it'll be interesting to see whether the coaching staff have got enough courage to take Irene van Dijk off the court.
Do you know what? I'd quite like to see it. Just, you know, it would interest me to see it. With Thompson at goal attack and Tutaia in the back, or Griffin with Tutaia.
Another mistake from the Silver Ferns. So it goes down the other end for the World 7. Showing again good patience.
I'd quite like to see what Paula Griffin's got. You know, she's been in this team for a long time now, and she doesn't get many opportunities. This could be the time for her to get on and show what she can do.
Well, that's certainly what the coaching staff are wanting from this series, to look at different options. There she is, Paula Griffin. She's just come back. Understandably didn't play in the first test. She'd been away with the New Zealand number 21s.
Crowd lifting with that intercept.
Lovely delivery from Wilcox. Beautiful. Read the space nicely and good strong pass. And finished off beautifully as well.
Finally rewards for some good work that's been done down the other end. Dean again going back. Dean, both Silver Ferns defenders back.
Well done, Casey Williams. Where's the support?
Is out of court.
Oh, unlucky. Thought she'd done that beautifully.
Well, she's been working hard, but not much that's coming off for Casey Williams. Langman with the tip. Finally, they get it.
Langman seems more at home back at centre now, doesn't she? It's been hard for her. She's been shifted around all over the show, been a wing attack, a centre, started off in the wing defence position originally.
So good to see a little bit of flow for the Silver Ferns finally.
A little bit of fight backs giving this crowd a little bit of hope.
Yes, the quarter score 6-8 now to the World 7. Oh, slippery floor.
Well done, Langman. Oh.
It's very hard to do that without stepping, to fall on the ground and get up without stepping, so she did do extremely well. But unfortunately, just the delivery not there.
Mentor
Scholes. Much better defensive work, really slowing that ball down coming out to the attack end. Defence end, rather, from the World 7.
So a mistake from the World 7. See what the Silver Ferns can do with it. Titaia, though, not happy to put that shot up.
Yeah, there's not a lot on in that circle. Temapara George had great positioning on the circle edge, but no one to throw to.
The defence of McCloma and Mantua have got really good angles on the attack players, so you can't actually see that space well on that feed. I mean, you'd know that, Jenny May, as a feeder. You know, you've got to see a space before you let that ball go.
Casey Williams throwing her body on the line, comes up with it, trying to spur her players on. Another mistake. It's just a comedy of errors. It really is.
Well, Casey Williams has been doing the work. She's had 7 intercepts in the game so far. Early days and 7 intercepts. Pretty outstanding. And here's number 7. Great skills. Have 2 hands on that ball.
So the crowd trying to G up this Silver Ferns defensive end.
Much better.
Yeah, much better switching from Jolene Henry and Casey Williams. Got around on that attacking player to have a go at the ball.
Langman finds George. Nice passing cut from George. Chocolate and Scholes all over her though. Again, nothing on for the Ferns. Laura Langman having to go back to the transverse line.
I just felt the ball could have gone in from Temapara George there, though. I felt that that time Van Dyke did have a good angle and Mentor was quite flat. I thought it was a good space if it had gone early.
Well, I guess it's confidence.
It's backing yourself on it.
And after having a couple of your balls that you've thrown dropped, you do lose your nerve a little bit.
Or intercepted, exactly.
That's better timing from Van Dyke. Took Mentor with her, opened up the space on the baseline. Nicely seen by Laura Langman.
So finally, one ahead in this quarter. New Zealand, 9-8.
It's been a long time coming, that's for sure.
Yep, still 7 goals to haul back.
Great work again from Williams. Henry back there, helping her out.
Maybe they can haul one more back before the end of this quarter.
It's a pocket.
Nice drive from Tutaia, made herself available nicely.
And a big rebound from McCloma.
Yeah, the World 7 have been strong on those New Zealand rebounds. They've won all 4 of them. Well, they've won 4 of them.
Scholes to McCloma. Not enough time, though, to put the ball through the hoop. And the Silver Ferns in disarray in the second test against the World 7. They've got a lot to do. Well, they've got a lot of work to do coming up in the second half as they trail the World 7, 16-23.
The Silver Ferns, they will be terribly disappointed and they have a long way to come back to try and get back into this match. And I'm guessing, Julie, the stats aren't pretty either.
Well,
The stat for me is that shooting percentage for New Zealand, and of course the scoreline, just New Zealand not getting the ball into their shooters. Unbelievable low score again in the second quarter of this match. Just 8-9. So both teams kept under 10, so very defensive game in that respect. Turnovers, well, New Zealand a bit untidy in that area, but not many more than that of the World 7. And intercepts they've got a lot of, really.
So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half of this game. And Tamsin Greenway, the England international, has really played exceptionally well tonight. She's got 17 caps for England. She's played most of her netball in the last 2 years over in Queensland, and really has been a revelation in this match against the Silver Ferns. Has just done her job and done it well.
Yes, it certainly has been a slick performance from the World 7 so far. There were four positional changes after the first quarter. To have a little reaction to that, we've got Jordan Vandermeid standing by with the Netball New Zealand president, Lois Muir.
Lois, first of all, your thoughts on the game so far?
Everyone always wants to know that. Well, we've got a bit of fire in our bellies now, so I think we're on the haul. But it looks like Marmelda Aiken's warming up, so that'll be a bit of a challenge for them.
It will be.
Timber.
Absolutely. Now, what do you think the girls need to do to move forward and get this deficit back a little bit?
Well, they've started it. They lack the drive-through court, and they didn't back each other. You know, you've got to let the ball go, and it's pretty hard out there. Strangely enough, this is just a new New Zealand team. We've picked it pretty short. They've had a short build-up.
Now, Lois, you're also involved in the legends and superstars of the Silver Ferns. A question, are you a legend or a superstar?
Oh, I don't know. I've just been around a long time. I don't know.
A legend and a superstar. Well, Lois, enjoy the night. Thanks heaps.
See you. So just to recap that score, 23-16 at halftime. Stay with us, second half coming up after the break. Get back into it here at halftime at Rotorua. The score is 23-16. The Silver Ferns playing a bit of catch-up. And Curry, any more changes? The Ferns have already made a few. I doubt they can do many more.
No, that's right. It would have been good probably to see a change to the shooting lineup, given those stats, but I haven't been notified of any from their bench. It looks like we may have some changes from the World 7, possibly seeing Romelda Aitken, who's a huge talent at just 20 years of old, coming on, and Althea Byfield, who brings her experience into the game. So we'll see a bit of Jamaican flair out there.
Well, it'll be great to see both those Jamaicans out on court at some stage, but it is the Silver Ferns who've got plenty to worry about as they head into this third quarter. They trail the World 7 16-23 in what has been an error-ridden performance from them. Stunned, really.
It's interesting just to look at them now off court at the moment, and the World 7 seem quite united and together. New Zealand are a bit disjointed. And that's what they like on court as well. The World 7 just seems so relaxed and out there and enjoying it, and there just seems to be so much pressure on this young Silver Fern side.
Well, I'm going to have to make a correction to my call before about Althea Byfield. She is coming on, but she's coming into the position of wing defence for this World 7. So this is going to be exciting to see. This girl creates a lot of havoc when she's in at goal peak, so we can only imagine what she can do out at wing defence.
Well, we talked about a rangy defence with McCloma and Mentor. Just wait and have a look at this, because she brings some rangy play on court as well, Byfield.
So Jamaican flair on the court in the form of Althea Byfield at wing defence, a position we're not used to seeing her play in. Nevertheless, I'm pretty sure she'll make a pretty good go of it. Silver Ferns, though, plenty of work to do. Nice pass, though, from Tutaia. It's the smile returning to Irene van Dijk's face.
So this World 7 side, great tip from George. They seem to be revved up a little more.
Well, they were revved up in the first quarter as well for the first couple.
And there we go, Mentor with the turnover again. Just talking about this World 7 side, four nations make up this World 7 side. Tonight, no New Zealand-born Samoans on the court, or New Zealand-based Samoans on court. It's the English, the Australians and the Jamaicans.
Well, we're lucky to have Silver Ferns coach Ruth Aitken standing by with us. And Ruth, not a pretty sight to see Silver Ferns. A lot of errors. What did you say to them at halftime?
Yeah, certainly we've got to tidy up our basics. It's, we're giving turnover ball far too cheaply. And then in the end, we actually have to connect on attack. We're working hard individually, but we're not getting those links. So it's all about the links.
Why is that, Ruth, do you think?
Well, I think
if we could put it...
Yeah, I think there is pressure, but in the end, we've got to step up. So, you know, the players just out there have just got to do it. They've got to work harder.
Thank you for your time, Ruth. Really appreciate it. So she wants to see the links better between the Silver Ferns. Not much of that happening, that's for sure. Oh, and we've got Aitken on the court.
Yes, the two Jamaicans on court now with Byfield at wing defence and Rimalda Aitken in the goal shoot position. Haven't seen them in the competition to date, so first showing.
Well, we've got the World 7 coach sitting by Julie Fitzgerald. You'd have a smile on your face, wouldn't you, Julie? This team's not doing too bad.
No, I thought we took our foot off the pedal a little bit towards the end of the second half, but it's good to see that we've come out fighting now.
Always a perfectionist.
How difficult is it being, Julie, to mould this team together? It doesn't seem like you've had much difficulty at all.
No, look, I have to say I am immensely proud of them. They've worked so hard together and they've talked about everything and they've really, really worked on this game. It hasn't just happened. So I'm very, very proud of them and I'm really grateful that it's coming off for them as well.
And is your plan to play, you know, like players from the same country together? Clearly that's sort of been a pattern.
It's really just worked out that way. And it wasn't that deliberate as it's turned out, but as it is working out quite well.
Thanks for your time, Julie. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Williams, beside herself, she's trying very hard to try and turn that ball over. It's not dropping for her, though, but it is for Megan Dean. Nice take from George. And again, van Dijk just moving off that hold slightly. So her feet are hesitating, don't want to give it.
Nice delivery that time from Tutaia and better hold from van Dijk. The World, though, leading this quarter again in early stages, 5-2.
Dean Greenway has been impressive so far in this match. Yes, pass is always going to go from Dean.
Well, they're playing the short pass too on attack, aren't they? The three passes we saw there in that final delivery into the circle, quite short, difficult for the defence to get in between.
Tutaia having to do a lot of work.
Yes.
Trying to get that circle moving.
Well, she's having to because they're giving a lot of attention to Irene van Dijk, aren't they? Two players back on here.
Chocolate, McClymer. Greenway with a big pass, and of course she's used to feeding Rimalda Aitken. They play together at the Queensland Firebirds in the Trans-Tasman competition.
Confident on it, wasn't she? Just turned, sighted and let it go. Mind you, one-on-one, Aitken should get it.
Oh, Henry employing the same strategy, turn, let it go.
I think she's hurt herself. I think she's hurt. You very rarely see Irene van Dijk call for time.
Yeah, it looked like she rolled her right ankle by the looks of it on the landing.
Let's have a look and see what's happened. McCloma, yeah, still on McCloma's foot. It's a long way to fall for van Dijk. But you're right, Julie. I don't even know if I've seen Irene take time.
Take time before, no. It's very rare.
Incredible, really, for the amount of, the number of tests that she's played to not have, you know, been off the court for injury at all.
Nope.
She's had 93 tests for New Zealand and 72 for South Africa. Phenomenal, really, isn't it?
Wow. Will we see a change? Let's have another look at it. So McCloma was out wide.
Yeah. Don't think she did it that badly. When she sort of landed, she moved it quite quickly, didn't she? So wasn't a real one of those ugly ones that rolls right over.
So New Zealand trail the world 7-11. Really started from that first quarter, 7:15 to the world. So what's the call? The Silver Ferns will have it. It was a contact on McCloma. 10 the difference. There's those 3-foot guard over Greenway, making sure she's not looking into that circle to Romelda Aiken. And Aiken just... Casey Williams goes up, Aiken puts one hand up, tips it back to herself. Too easy. Yes, not taken in the centre third. Another basic error from the Silver Ferns. Unacceptable.
Yeah, look, that must be frustrating for the coaching staff. I mean, I coach a school team and I'd be all over them for those sort of errors, and they're the same errors that they were making on Monday night.
Aiken called for pushing back on Casey Williams.
Only 20 years of age, Aiken, and 1.96 metres.
Nice work from Temapara George there.
Tutai, I thought that one was going in. She walked away. Tidy up from the Ferns. And McCloma in there again.
That long reach of McCloma's spoils.
Garbage outside and contact wear.
Tutai, she doesn't like that lean from McCloma. Not from distance anyhow.
Nice fake from Laura Langman.
Yeah, much better splitting of the defenders from Irene van Dijk and Maria Tutai.
And chocolate, easy feed into Aiken. Casey Williams hanging off her. From Megan Dean. Now, there's the England coach, Sue Hawkins, to your right there. She'll be pretty happy with the way that her charges are playing tonight.
Yes, she's been out for the World Youth Champs in the Cook Islands and came across for this series.
She'll be wanting to know from Julie Fitzgerald what she said to those defenders to keep Irene van Dijk where she is on the scoreboard.
Well, that was really interesting, that last bit from Casey Williams. She looked at Megan Dean as if to say, you're not 3 foot, and then just flicked the ball off. That type of body language tells me, you know, she's not happy with the way things are going, but looking at the umpire for the calls, it ain't going to come.
And here we have a break, I think. Another error that they can't afford.
Yep, that's the 32nd turnover for the New Zealand team. Just the 26 from the World 7.
So the Ferns, a lot of turnovers. Not a mistake there from Byfield. Misunderstanding between her and Greenway.
And the other thing, and we know this, is just that centre pass score. New Zealand only scoring 15 of their 28 centre pass off. So it shows there quite clearly that it's breaking down from that midcourt to into the shooters.
Nice pass from Timmy Potter George.
Turnovers, they're both scoring a similar rate off the others, although again the World 7 slightly better in that area as well. Long ball this time, Van Dijk right on the edge of the circle though, no shot option from there.
Chocolate went for the ball. Laura Langman was standing there though. Long arms of Byfield trying to disrupt the play. McCloma.
I really think that the Silver Ferns could fake the English defenders a little more. They're both very aerial and they'll go for a ball in flight. A little bit more fake could help.
Byfield, Greenway. Right in that pocket for Dean though, it's going to be easy passing.
I think the thing about the English defence for the World 7 as well, I think they've been quite disciplined in their play, and sometimes when they're playing for England, they have ill discipline creeps in.
Well, McCloma, she's been impressive tonight.
But I think they've perhaps learnt that discipline from playing in the ANZ Championship and now here in these internationals.
Well, I'm not sure what happened there, but the Silver Ferns have come away with the ball. George has to go back to the transverse to try and get herself onto that circle edge to make it easier to feed. Tutaia trying to take the defence off Van Dijk.
And it dribbles out, and the rebound again claimed by the World 7.
So it's a contact call on Van Dijk,
and the rebounds have been very strong from the World 7. Look at that, 7 defensively. So McCloma and Mentor very strong on those missed shots from New Zealand.
Steph called on McCloma. Relief for the Silver Ferns as they get the ball again in hand. George Tutaia, bad defence back on Van Dijk.
Nice timing, nice delivery. Let's have some more of that, please. So a better scoring quarter. We're up in double figures for both teams now.
Dean searching, has to go all the way over to Byfield. Greenway with that big pass. Again, Williams getting stuck on Aiken. So a timeout called here by one of the World 7 players, I think. Yes, it's Natasha Chocolate, the centre for the World 7.
Yeah, she's got a bit of blood coming out of her knee, so got to patch that up and get her back on. Interesting coming into this timeout, Jolene Henry giving Larissa Wilcox a bit of a hurry up in terms of getting over the ball and just helping Casey out with Romelda Aiken on the baseline.
Yes, well, she's doing a bit of damage, isn't she, Romelda Aiken? On Monday night, it was Catherine Latu, the Samoan international. Tonight, it's the 20-year-old from Jamaica.
Well, Brownfield did quite well as well.
True.
You know, she, the English international at goal shoot. But I think it all comes down to Dean. She creates, she's a true goal attacker, isn't she? She creates beautiful space in there for a shooter. She doesn't crowd them, and she delivers the ball beautifully to them. Reads the game really well. A very experienced head.
Not bad for someone who was playing a bit of tennis at the beginning of the year and running the odd half marathon. Came back for the steal and was the difference. And she's certainly been the difference for this World 7 side. Not a player you always notice, but she's always doing a lot of work. Bit of space created by Van Dijk and a nice delivery from George.
Langman and George combining quite nicely in this quarter. Certainly better than the options we've seen in the mid. Oh, and again, she just hauls it in, doesn't she? Elevator arms. George, strong off the line on that centre pass.
Yeah, no one to pass to down court, though, with Tutei in that circle.
Mentor is just putting so much pressure on Irene van Dijk. Every ball she takes is difficult.
Well, look at that. You look at Mentor's body, and that was a great delivery to van Dijk.
A great dodge from Irene on the baseline.
The good old basic skills. Have a look at them, everyone. Dodge one way, take the defence, and leave yourself beautiful space.
Want to see it a little bit more often, don't we, Julie?
Absolutely. We need a few more of those. Still down one in this quarter as well. 12-13 to the world. Make that 12-14. But a better quarter for the Silver Ferns. Glimpses of hope.
Tutei coming to the top of the circle, trying to leave the pressure from van Dijk. She does it. Dean. Big pass across court.
Yes, using the whole court, the World 7, trying to open up some space.
Henry goes looking for the ball, but is called for the contact.
Disappointed as well, as is the crowd.
Well, look good. And Williams jumps the shot, but it's just an easy feed to Aiken. Henry gives away that height.
Lovely delivery from Megan Dean, perfect timing.
And Aiken hasn't missed a shot yet, 12 from 12.
That's better.
Yes, that time got Mentor on her back. Held good space.
Greenway, of course, we didn't see her on the court in the first test. Frances Sullier, Samoan captain, had the wing attack live on. Greenway, be enjoying her time out on court.
New Zealand, that's one of the areas that they've been penalised a lot more than that of the World 7. So just letting the World 7 off the hook at times.
And George trying to let that ball go to go straight into Irene van Dijk to see if they could score at the end of this third period. But they still lag behind this World 7 side. And it is 9 goals the difference, 39 in favour of the World 7, 30 to the Silver Ferns. Seven having plenty to say at the three-quarter time break. And the Silver Ferns need to get their act together with just 15 minutes left to play in the second test. Ferns were beaten 44-48 in game one, and that's a good start to this final quarter.
Yes, Wilcox did very well. Read the cross-court ball. She's come on well. She certainly must have had good trials to be brought in from outside the squad, Larissa Wilcox, and you can see she's an athlete. She's certainly an athlete. There she is on your screen now, the wing defender.
They need four more insets like that to be back in the game, the Silver Ferns. So need her to get a little bit more.
And a contact called on Mentor. Good work early on from the Silver Ferns as they bridge this gap, 7 the difference. Megan Dean. She just finished saying to Natasha Chocolate at the quarter break, keep your head up because I want to pass the ball back to you. She had her head down.
Yeah, they all showed leadership, didn't they, the World Seven? They were all talking amongst each other and helping each other out.
And again, one-on-one, Casey Williams caught on the back of Romelda Aitken.
Where you are now.
So Dean taking the shot, so if it doesn't go in, Romelda Aitken's under the post to rebound. And a step called by the umpire on Langman. Pressure, you'd have to say, has certainly got to the Silver Ferns in this match. Put under the pump after that loss in the first test.
Aitken really doesn't like to shoot from distance, does she? And that was an air ball, didn't go anywhere near the goal. She likes it from right under the post.
Yeah, lucky to come away with that one, misunderstanding.
It was, wasn't it? Yeah. Tutuaia just let the ball go, whereas Langman was waiting to dodge back and make herself available more in clean air.
Oh, big pass that wasn't really on.
Nice. You could see the space there. Delivered well, taken well.
After a slow start, Van Dijk's up at 87% now, shooting. Dean, into that pocket. Pinpoint accurate, that pass.
Yeah, 87% for Van Dijk, but only 65 for Tutuaia, and you know, that 77% stat there for New Zealand is not going to win you a test match.
Yes.
So it just shows how menacing McCloma and Mentor have been over those shots for New Zealand.
World 7 all over the ball. Nice dish off from Tutuaia.
And again, so disciplined on that distance, but just jumped in that time and hit the ball in the hand of Van Dijk. And that was very ill-disciplined. Just building them up for being disciplined. And they can't do that.
But it, you'd have to say, Julie, that it is a more disciplined game from McCloma. She usually gets a lot more penalties, so obviously Julie Fitzgerald's had some impact there.
Yes, she's only had 9 contacts and 2, 4 obstructions, so quite tidy. Yes, Casey Williams has had 13 contacts and 5 obstructions, so...
Well, she's not happy with the umpire at this point in time, but she got caught on the back again of Romelda Aitken.
Really need your other defence around you helping you out when you're up against the height of Romelda Aitken.
Yep.
Your outside defenders and your goal defence helping you out at times.
Well, I think Megan Dean is making it. And Williams out of court.
Outstanding work that just tipped over the baseline. She couldn't have done any more.
A good battle going on between Aitken and Williams. Aitken, though, doesn't faze her. I don't think the expression on her face ever changes.
Can you believe she's only 20 years of age?
Yeah.
Poor customer. Quite a heavily bound right knee as well.
Langman at the top of the circle. Tutuaia again to roll the top. Seven in the difference. It's a pass again from Dean back to Chocolate. Dean looking for that little pass, pop up and over.
And just that wide stance on the landing from Aitken, and she does well, Williams.
Was out outstanding from Williams. She jumped the shot.
She actually got it inside.
Henry is at 3 foot mark from the World Seven, really slowing up the speed from the Ferns.
Timing just not quite there on attack, is it?
No. That's because there's a 3 foot marker in front. So, you know, they're going on the first second, but the ball can't go on the first second because there's a 3 foot guard.
Exactly.
And have to clear the arms. So the timing.
So the timing of the player coming for the ball has to be slightly delayed. Gives the time with the passer to get rid of the defence from in front.
And despite Mentor getting a hand on that ball, goes through the hoop.
New Zealand 7-4 up in this quarter, so much better performance, but maybe too little too late.
Henry, George, man. Whether the ball slipped out of her hands there, but Chocolate was there to tidy things up.
Oh, no love lost either. A grimace on her face as she struggled free.
Megan Dean, you know, you've got Aiken in there creating a headache for Williams, but Megan Dean is certainly doing that for Jolene Henry. Get it in, so I'll tip it to the teammate.
Yeah.
See if she can get it in.
Just getting those rebounds as well.
Now this lady here, Julie Fitzgerald, will be enjoying having this group of players. Wasn't a successful Trans-Tasman campaign for her. The reigning champs ended up in ninth position. So, bit of success for her finally this season. Langman coming around for the intercept call, though, for the contact. Yeah, contact on the ball from Williams. Henry puts her head down. She's just thinking, well, there's nothing I can do. Well, everything I'm doing, I'm getting pulled for. Absolute and utter frustration from the Silver Ferns and for the fans as well. Comer driving down court, finds Greenway. Dean, that little pocket once again.
One-on-one up against 1.96 metres. It's Aiken over Williams again.
Good take from George.
She holds space well, doesn't she, on the edge of the circle. Strong body stance. Tutuaia with the penalty. Percent for Tutuaia.
And again, that pocket is way open. Williams now too scared to go out in case the ball goes straight into Aiken.
You've almost got to have a go for it outside, though, don't you? When it, you know, comes into the circle, it's all too little, too late, and they're not getting the rebounds of the 8 missed goals that the World Seven have made.
Yeah.
The Silver Ferns defence have only got one rebound.
Yeah, I agree, Julie. They've got to attack that ball outside. The World Seven are being really patient and bringing the ball down to the circle edge so that it is just Casey and Romelda one-on-one.
And they're playing it short at times, which, again, makes it difficult for that defence to get in between and get that ball.
That was just awful.
Only one word. Really ruling things.
Well, it sums it up, really.
On that drive through court, Chocolate just there for every second ball.
Well, I guess Chocolate never thought she'd play on the international stage again. done her part for this World 7.
You wonder whether it'll give her the revival to make herself available for Australia next year. She made herself unavailable this year due to work commitments.
Yes, that was a better space, but the pass just a little bit too much on it. Timing also from Van Dijk, a little off. Greenway, big pass again down to that pocket to Dean. And Aitken just picks the ball out of the air.
I just felt Dean needs to be kept on this side of the court, on the near side of the court. She was allowed, then Henry allowed her to run right across court and open the whole court up. And, you know, you, as a goal defence, wing defence, you've got to use the sidelines as another boundary and try and force your player to the sideline. Again, she's got that run right through the base.
Yeah, contact called on Casey Williams. Again, not happy. As I said earlier, frustration. Hasn't been a great start for her as a skipper for Silver Ferns.
Dean offloads to Aitken, who has not.
George to Taia. Chocolate all over Langman. And McClomer called for the contact, so it's a clear shot for Van Dijk.
Katrina Grant started in the first test.
Again, is that one-on-one to Aitken. Greenway.
Can't do
teammate.
Much about it.
No,
you
right.
need a player, a defence outsider, up and over that ball really early. Get in the face of the player delivering the ball to Aitken.
Yeah, good work there from Chocolate. That pass was into the space, but too far into the space. Tutaia, though, comes up with it.
Yep, good reply.
Again, too little too late for the Silver Ferns. They trail by 12. Tutaia again, rolling that circle. And puts a shot up.
She's having to do a lot of work, isn't she? Because Van Dijk has been caught under there with two defence on her that are very rangy. They can come off and go for ball as well in a very, very short distance.
Do you think Frances Solier is happy with her team? No, she might be, but I'd say the Silver Ferns camp will be very unhappy tonight.
Yes, well, we played a World 7 back in 2000 and lost the first test, as we did in this series. Only lost the second by one, not quite that margin tonight. I beg your pardon, won the second one by one, and then won the third by 13.
Yes, good defence there from the Silver Ferns and from George on Byfield. So she knows there's only a few seconds left, turns and lets it go down to Van Dijk. So they convert with 30 seconds left on the clock. It's all over though. Silver Ferns, it's been...
Well, they need this to draw the quarter. They haven't won a quarter at all in this match.
Mentor got a hand to it, but Van Dijk collects it, pulls it in.
So that's a drawn quarter, as they did in the first test, drew the last quarter, but as we've said, all too little, too late.
First, the Silver Ferns have been stunned by the World 7. They've been embarrassed after what can only be described as an awful, error-ridden performance. Plenty of soul-searching for New Zealand before Saturday's third and final test against the World 7. Beaten convincingly here in Rotorua tonight, 53-44.
Yes, I think a few alarm bells can start ringing now. After the first test, you know, you could understand not a lot of time together, new combinations, but it didn't gel again tonight. A lot of work to do prior to that third test.
Well, congratulations.
congratulations once again, Julie. Tell us, how did you mould this team so beautifully together in such a short period of time?
I think they did a lot of it themselves. They've been so enthusiastic, and we have worked really hard, and everything that they've talked through, they've worked together on it all.
Look, of particular note were your impressive defenders tonight, shutting down the world's best goal shooting, Irene van Dijk, in that first half. What did you work on this week with them?
I think we've tried to really maintain that one-on-one defence, and I'm really quite proud of Sonia because it's not a natural game for her, and I think she's worked really hard at it. And then for Althea to come out and play wing defence for us, she had a great game out there in a position that's very foreign to her.
Yeah, look, we wondered about that change. So why that one?
We knew we had to have a backup for Pete, that she was really the only wing defence in the team. So Althea's been working all week on being able to cover that position for us, so we thought we'd give her a crack, and I think she did a pretty good job, all things considered.
Well, well done, and we look forward to what else you bring out for us on Friday.
Thank you very much. Saturday.
Yeah, thanks.
I'm here with Ruth Aitken, coach of the Silver Ferns. And Ruth, everyone was expecting a better performance tonight after Monday. How do you explain tonight?
Oh, I think it's very difficult to explain, really. But in the end, we were just flat. We had good surges towards the end of quarters, but then we would start again poorly. And the personal error was just too high. So it's, you know, we're very disappointed and, it's no excuse.
I guess you're disappointed. Is there a sense of annoyance, too, at some of the mistakes out there tonight?
I think in the end, we felt that there was some players out there that had played quite a lot together and they should have been able to lift. The fact it didn't show the pressure that the world team had put on us, but we've got to be able to cope with that.
Absolutely. Australia next week. Is it a worrying thought losing by this much with Australia approaching?
Oh, look, for the Silver Ferns team to lose by this much to anyone is of course worrying. So we've got a lot of work to do, there's no doubt about it.
Okay, all the best for the third test.
Thank you.
And stay with us after the break. We'll have reaction from the two captains of this match and we'll announce our player of the match.
National Netball Series is proudly brought to you by New World. We love netball as much as you do.
Boom, boom, pow, them chickens jogging my style. They try to copy my swagger. I'm on that next shit now. I'm sold 3,008. You sold 2,000 and late. I got that boom, 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 that future boom, boom, boom. Let me get in that.
Boom, 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 gotta get that. Boom, 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 gotta get that. Boom, 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 gotta get that.
Welcome back to the Energy Events Centre. The score, the final score, 53-44. The Silver Ferns have been beaten by the World 7. Let's take a look at the stats, Julie Coney. Not pretty.
Well, the World 7 shot better, they rebounded better, and they were penalised less. The New Zealand team, of course, had more intercepts, but again, it just couldn't be finished off at the other end of the court.
I'm joined now by the captain of the World 7, Natasha Chocolate. Natasha, again, look, I mean, I'm stunned by the result given how the Silver Ferns performed, but you'd probably be pretty happy with your lot.
Yeah, we're extremely happy. The Ferns are a tough side, and tonight they proved they can swing players around and not lose a beat. So we're very happy they kept coming back, but the fact that we managed to get most of the players on court tonight and swing things around and still keep momentum and come out with a win, we're very, very happy.
So what have you been doing over the last couple of days? Because even though you did get players on, it still looked like a very cohesive team.
Yeah, it has been. We've just been just keeping things really, really simple, short and sharp. And when we did get a little bit fancy and throw some long balls, it wasn't working for us. So we just needed to steady, keep things short and play simple netball, which is what we did.
Yes, you did that. You did that very well. And so congratulations. And we look forward to seeing you again in Auckland on Saturday night.
Thanks very much. A day's extra rest, so we're happy about that. But yeah, we're looking forward to Auckland.
Appreciate your time. That was the captain of the World 7, Natasha Chocolate. And I'm joined now by the Silver Ferns skipper, Casey Williams. Hasn't been a pleasant captaining experience, I guess, for you, Casey, mate. Pretty awful out there, you know, with your team. I don't know. I really don't know what to say to you, and I'm pretty sure you're searching for answers yourself.
Yeah, definitely. But I definitely think the intensity has lifted. I'm absolutely knackered compared from the first game to this game. And going out to the last quarter, I said, you know, leave your guts out there. I want to drag you off the court, and I think that's what we did.
You guys did that. However, there were too many basic errors that you simply should not see from a Silver Fern side.
Definitely. It seems to be creeping into our game, and it's starting right from the start, not just when we're getting tired. So we really need to sharpen up and have a good start.
Just quickly, how are you going to turn that around though, Casey May?
Definitely, we don't like the losing feeling. We want to feel what it feels like to win. And, you know, we're going to be in trouble, and we're going to work hard and definitely come out fighting again.
I appreciate your time. All the very best for Saturday night against the World 7.
Thank you.
Well, disappointment there for Casey Williams, but one player who will be celebrating is our player of the match, Jeeva Mentor. She was all class tonight, very tight, never let Irene van Dijk have any room, and really caused a lot of problems for the Ferns attack tonight. She will certainly be a force for England this season. Jordan Vandermeid is standing by with Jeeva Mentor now.
Well, for years, Jeeva, I've got to say that they've tried to keep Irene under the caution. You, mate, you did a great job of it. What was your formula?
Oh, thanks. I mean, Irene's definitely a class player. I've had the benefit of being able to come up against her a few times this year. And with such a relaxed team out in front of me, we just go out there and have some fun, and it makes my work a lot easier.
Yeah, you guys must be absolutely stoked. I mean, now it's 2 from 2. Did you ever expect that? What's the mood going to be like in camp?
I mean, it's the most relaxed team I've been in. There's no pressure on us whatsoever. We're just going out there having fun. And I think it's really shown in our performances, and maybe we can tell our future coaches to come that that's the way to do it.
Absolutely. Well, Jeeva, you had a fantastic game. You are the player of the match. Congratulations. And we'll see you in Auckland, not for the decider, but to see if you guys can win 3-0. So well done.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Yes, a very happy Jeeva Mentor. The final score, if you missed it, 53-44. The Silver Ferns have lost to the World 7. Stay with us. We'll have more reaction here from the Energy Events Centre after the break. Williams said the intensity was increased, but the end result was the same for the Silver Ferns. They've been beaten by the World 7. Jenny May, Julie, what did you make of that?
Yes, well, the Silver Ferns, it certainly was a fairly average performance, beaten 53-44 by the World 7. Julie, I put the question to Casey May, unacceptable to have that many basic errors, and it really is coming from a Silver Fern side. Shouldn't happen.
Well, there were a lot of errors from both teams tonight, actually. A lot more turnovers in tonight's match than in the first test. That was a stat I perhaps didn't point out. And I think that was reflected in the score in the second quarter. Such a low-scoring second quarter, neither team getting to double figures. So there were errors in both ends, but very disappointing for the Silver Fern side. I thought they may have been able to turn this test around.
Well, look, many people will say, OK, Silver Ferns haven't had that much time together, but neither have the World 7. Right. So you can't use that as an excuse.
There's some very experienced heads in that World 7 side. They are some classy, classy players. And I think, as Jeeva Mentor said, there's no pressure on them at all, Jenny May. They have gone out there and they look like they're enjoying their netball out on court. The Silver Ferns almost look scared.
Well, there was certainly a lot of pressure on the Silver Ferns, but it is a big international calendar and the Silver Ferns have plenty more netball still to come.
Two tests are now complete against the World 7. The final match is in Auckland on Saturday. The first of the Trans-Tasman tests will start in Sydney next week, followed by a test in Melbourne and then one in Brisbane. The road trip moves back to New Zealand for the final two tests, first off in Invercargill, then the series decider in Auckland, then the big trip to Manchester for the World Series, a one-off test against England and Bath before stopping off in Jamaica to play them in a one-off test as well.
So the next match we have, the third and final match against the World 7, is on Saturday night at Trust Stadium in Auckland. Remember, that's exclusively live from One Sport at 7:30. Yes, very hard to explain this loss tonight. Kerry, if you had to pinpoint one or two players that didn't perform well, who would you say?
Look, to me they all look mentally flat, and perhaps it's something to do with the trials going in, that they're fighting for positions and then all of a sudden they're back into the mix. Yeah, I can't pinpoint any, but I have to say probably Irene didn't have her best game tonight. Really flat. Jeeva Mentor was all over it.
How worried are you? We've got Australia next week. Can we recover from this? I mean, it's a huge amount of goals.
Yeah, look, it is worrying going in. We've got to hope that this build-up will give them the shock that they obviously need to really tidy up some of those basic errors that they've been doing.
OK, well, let's hope that it all comes right for the Silver Ferns when we head to Auckland. It can only be described as a horror night here in Rotorua. Fingers crossed it improves for Saturday. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you then.
Thanks for watching tonight's match. See you at the next one.
Here we go. Gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.